All right, good evening and welcome from Culver Community High School. Steve Stricker alongside Andy Stone.
Hello, hello, and here we go.
We've got game number 3 of the Culver sectional number 51 coming your way. It's the first round of the sectional, and it's going to be your Argus Lady Dragons. And they're going to be taking on the Lady Trojans from Triton High School for the third time this season. We've got 3 of the 4 semifinal contestants already set. It's La Crosse and South Central. La Crosse had the bye, and South Central defeated South Bend Career Academy in the only game here last night by a score of 83-23. And in the game we just saw here prior to this one, North Miami advances by a score of 51-10 over the host Culver Community Cavaliers. And they will await the winner of the game here this evening between Argus and Triton. Well, Andy, the Lady Dragons come into tonight's game ranked number 3 in the state in Class A. They're 19-2 on the year, and they're going to take on a Lady Trojan team that's 8-14 on the year. And we've seen them twice already this season. The first game earlier in the year was a little bit of a blowout for the Lady Dragons, and just a little over a week and a half ago, they came over to Argus for round number 1 of the Bi-County and gave the Lady Dragons a little bit of a scare. Took a one-point lead in the fourth quarter, and Lady Dragons were able to come back.
Well, the biggest thing is, it's the old saying is it's super hard to beat a team 3 times in one season, but you know what? Records don't show everything about the games, doesn't show everything about the players, and that's why you're here. You're loving the postseason, sectional time. It's time to step up or step out. So I think the Lady Dragons are going to come in big. We already know that the Lady Trojans went to a box and won on Dunlap. They're going to have to watch Dunlap and Stricker, the two hot-handed shooters for the team, the last few games out. Stricker coming off Plymouth Pilots Athlete of the Week. I don't know if you noticed that.
Did notice that.
So it's a nice little honor for her. Dunlap's going to have Whitney Miller on her, if I remember right. Yeah, Whitney Miller will be on her most of the game. But, you know, the Dragons can do it. Triton has a far better team than the 8-14 record shows. I got to give them props. Coach has done well with really getting them turned around here towards the end of the season. So,
well, the last two games of the year for the Lady Dragons really gave me a lot of hope. They went last Thursday and they defeated LaVille by 21 points in their senior night over at Phil Waybright Gymnasium. And then the game that I really liked, three quarters of it anyway, was they went up to Westville in the season finale on Saturday night and beat a much improved Westville team that had won 13 games on the year. The thing that they did, though, they adjusted. They were down 14-7 early in the first quarter. They made an adjustment. They went to a box and won on Mary Parkman, who's the coach's daughter and a 1,000-point career scorer for the Lady Blackhawks. And once they did that, they put Kennedy Binkley on her, and I tell you what, she had like 3 points the rest of the game. And they're going to have to do that here tonight. Triton's main scorer is the junior Hannah Wanamaker. Once you get past Hannah, the scoring drops off considerably. They've got a few girls in the 3 to 4 point per game range, but Wanamaker is their main threat. They struggle scoring even last Saturday in their season finale. They went into triple overtime with North Judson and only put up 34 points in that game in triple overtime. So I think the Dragons' defense is going to come up big. I think they're going to run box and one against Wanamaker. And I think the thing for the Dragons, and this is something you don't normally say about the Dragons, is they got to turn up the tempo a little bit here tonight.
Yep.
Normally they say, you know, let's slow it down. Let's go at more of a Dragon pace. But I think tonight they've got to turn it up. They've got to force Triton to try and keep up with the scoring. The Lady Dragons are putting up 53 points a game. And If they get anywhere near that 50 to 60 point range, Triton's not going to be able to keep up with them. They just don't have the horses that can score that.
Well, I want to see it. Just like I said before, I want us to come out, catch the team off guard, and get 10 quick points and really show them who's going to be running this game. We did it against Michigan City Marquette, and I tell you what, we play with that type of tenacity, speed, and really quality. There's not going to be a team around that's going to compete with us for a long time to come. But the Dragons have got to do it. They got to go after it. No holds barred, quality basketball, keep control, no silly turnovers, and just hit their shots. I love the fact that we were taking a lot of high percentage shots last game.
Well, yeah, they. I think another thing that happened when they went to that box and won, they had Morgan and Macy up top, which allowed them to get out, use their speed. Morgan and Macy both have some pretty good speed, and that allowed them to get out front, and they got a lot of easy buckets off of layups that way. So the coaches for both teams, of course, Argus is headed by Gary Teal, who's 77-36 in five seasons with the Dragons. He's 235-146 and 17 years overall. Adam Heckeman is the head man for the Triton Lady Trojans. Coach Heckeman is 107-94 in nine seasons with Triton. Last time out, as we mentioned, the Lady Dragons defeated Westville 62-37, and Triton lost to North Judson in a three overtime game, 37-34. The series over the last 15 years, Triton leads 15-8, and their last meeting was January 17th, which Argus won 37-29. Predicted score 46-32 here tonight, so hopefully the Lady Dragons can even do a little better than that. I think if, like you said, they come out all guns blazing, ready to go, they're going to be in good shape. Triton is in the home whites tonight, so Lady Dragons will be the guests on the scoreboard. They're wearing their black travel uniforms here this evening.
The Black Dragons.
So,
well, I tell you what, there's a lot of fans from the other teams, especially, obviously, from the winners of the first match, definitely not leaving. They want to see what's in store. North Miami's paying attention, and actually the coach is coming right here in front of us. And he's just going to sit, wait, and look at some of the stats and watch what happens as this game plays out.
Should be a good one here tonight. We thank everybody here at Culver Community and John R. Nelson Gymnasium for their hospitality. And I know Andy got his fill of the hot dogs and pizza and the complimentary
Coney dogs.
Coney dogs over there from Culver. So we're going to get going here. Starting lineups going to start with the Lady Dragons, the visitors on the scoreboard.
At this time, I would like to introduce the starting lineups for tonight's sectional 51 matchup between the visiting Dragons and the Triton Trojans. First for the visitors on the scoreboard, the Argus Dragons.
Yeah. Oh, it's postseason, baby. I love it. Number 10, Courtney Dunlap.
Number 24, Macy.
Number 22, Kennedy Binkley. Number 24, Macy Stricker. Number 30, Emily Calhoun. And number 50, Anna Barlow. And for your Lady Trojans,
number
10, Quinn Downing.
Number 12,
Hannah Wanamaker.
Number
14, Whitney Miller.
Number
22,
Nicole
Secret. And number 24, Courtney Jennings.
All right, here we go. Two teams are out on the floor, and let's see what... what kind of game plan? This is going to be a little bit of a chess match here. You've played a team twice already in the year. So what adjustments is Coach Teal going to make? What adjustments is Coach Heckman going to make? And what adjustment are the girls going to make here? So it ought to be an interesting game here. It's always difficult to beat a team, no matter what their record, three times in a row. You see some lacrosse players here making their way in. They want to do a little scouting. They're not going to be in action until Friday.
Yep.
But they got high hopes of making it into the finals after they beat South Central last week in the Porter County Conference game. So it's going to be number 22 to Seacrest.
tipped, and it's going to be Argus' ball. Over and back.
Well, I don't know. Calhoun was on this side of the line, and she saw she was there, so that's a turnover for the Lady Dragons early here.
All right. We, first of all, we want to apologize for all the fans that watch this now instead of live. We tried to go live, and it's not our system. It's just the internet, and that's just how it goes. Barlow with a block, and there it starts already.
Barlow. Starting off where she left off at West Center, Westville.
Westville with what?
12 blocks on
12
the game.
Blocks.
New
the
record
game.
For a single game for a Lady Dragon player. Previous record was 10.
And here comes the Lady Trojans, gets the ball across the timeline.
That was a smart play by Sechrist. Yep. You know, you don't touch it before it goes over. There's no foul there.
Wanamaker goes up. Jennings misses. Rebound. And Barlow with a foul.
And that's not a good sign. Anna Barlow gets a quick foul here with 7:28 left to go. Sechrist is going to be at the line shooting two for the Lady Dragons. Trojans.
Well, you know what? For some reason, we double-teamed Wanamaker. She made that run. Let her go. Let her earn it first before you worry about putting two people on her.
Yeah, I don't know why they were doing that.
I don't
thought
know
the box in one
that
would be
or
sufficient.
The rotation didn't pay attention. And the second one goes in. The Dragons down by one.
Sechrist gets the first points of the game.
Well, let's see what happens. Box in one, and they don't have Miller.
They got
on
Downing on
Downing
Dunlap.
On Dunlap, and that's... I thought Miller did an outstanding job, unless they want Downing on there at first, and then Miller when she has fresh legs later on in the game. Calhoun fakes, kicks it back over. Stricker to Dunlap. Forces it through.
She gets the bucket to go between three Trojans and gets the foul, so Dunlap's going to go to the line.
Artist number 10, Courtney Dunlap. She'll go to the line.
I don't know how she forced that through, but man,
well, she went up with a lot of power there. Who did they call that foul on? Number 10.
Number 10.
Quinn Downing gets the foul. And the free throw for Dunlap is good. So she gives the Dragons a 3-1 lead here with 6:56 left to go.
I want to see the Dragons go after it. Now Binkley's on Wanamaker, and Wanamaker's not going to be happy. Binkley's face Gardner. And there's a steal by the Dunlap. Ball's loose and is stolen again. Back over the other way. Just about stolen from Dunlap again. Could have been a foul called there, but you know what? I like the way it's going so far. They kick it tipped. Fakes. Kicks it out to Downing.
Downing's got a .5 point per game average, so
yeah,
she's not
going
to look to score.
Let her shoot. Ball's in. Fakes. Barlow misses. Rebound goes to Stricker. And here comes the Dragons, and that's the pace I want. Quickly down the court. Set it up. Here comes Calhoun out. Gets the ball. Dunlap makes a run. Gives it over to Stricker. Binkley kicks it out. Calhoun. Travels. That's turnover.
Oh, three early turnovers here for the Dragons. Two of them committed by Emily Calhoun. And Coach Teal's going to be looking here. He's trying to figure out what's going on in the head with the senior player, Emily Calhoun. He's trying to get her in the game here.
Set or down. It's early on. There's not much to it. Quick jumper. Way off the mark. Rebound.
Blocked. Oh.
Kennedy Binkley with the foul.
Well, we can already tell what the pace of this game is going to be as far as the referees go. They're going to call it a lot tighter than we saw up at Westville, for sure.
Yeah, Westville is kind of a WrestleMania-type deal.
So Wanamaker puts the first free throw in, gives the Lady Trojans their second point of the game. She's going to look to tie it up here with her second free throw. And it's off the mark, and rebound goes out of bounds off of Jennings, and it's going to be Dragons ball.
Well, let's see what happens. They might rotate. I figured Downing got one foul. They switched, and Miller goes over to Dunlap. There's a screen. Rotates through. Stricker comes out. Over to Binkley. So they know Stricker's a shooter. They rotate out quick on her. They don't worry about Binkley with the shot.
Calhoun for three. And it's just off the mark.
Barlow's got to be smart right there. She almost went over the back of Sechrist. Morgan Dunlap's going to check in for the Lady Dragons.
And Binkley is all over Wanamaker. She's going to earn her keep tonight. Shot by Jennings, and it's in.
Courtney Jennings puts the bucket in and gives the Lady Trojans a 4-3 lead with 4.5 minutes left to go in the first. Yeah, we got girls walking up the court. I don't get it. We're in sectional play here, girls. We got to get going.
Well, Calhoun saw Dunlap getting ready to sub, and she's already assuming it's her. Stricker misses the three. Ball's loose. And it's going to be tied up.
It's going to go to Triton on the jump ball. So much like at Westville here, the Lady Dragons is in a little bit of a funk here to start the game.
And Calhoun walks off.
Triton basketball.
Very upset.
All right, let's see what the Lady Dragons can get going with 4:15 left in the first. They're down 1 point, 4-3.
Well, this is not what we wanted. Boring and slow. We wanted fast pace and going after it. Pressing, working hard.
Well, you know Triton wants to slow it down because they have trouble putting the ball in the basket. So they're going to try and slow this game down. And right now it's going at their pace. 7 points
here. Moving screen. Kicked by Dunlap.
Only 7 points scored in the first five-plus minutes. So this pace right now favors the Lady Trojans.
Well, it doesn't favor us as announcers. I'll tell you that much. I want high-paced action. Down low, stolen, and knocked out of bounds by Barlow.
Trojan ball.
Well. Ball's in. Miller fakes. Freshman on the freshman. And it's tipped by Dunlap, and there's Steele. What a play by Courtney Dunlap. Tips it up off the glass. Has the presence of mind to get it. Now she's taking it right in. And it's in for another bucket and one.
Courtney Dunlap, second and one opportunity here. She's got all five of the Lady Dragons points here in the first quarter. Like the aggressiveness here of Dunlap. You push the ball up the floor. She got the steal. And now she's got a chance to make it two and ones, and she does. 6 points now for Courtney Dunlap, and the Lady Dragons are back up 6-4 with 3:20 left in the first quarter.
All right, here comes Downing across the timeline. Dragons up 6-4. Dunlap switches over. Ball's low. Can't get it in. Here's a quick little jumper out of Jennings, and the bank is open.
Well, Stricker got caught out of position right there, and Jennings takes advantage with a little 15-foot bank shot. Ties the game up at six.
Binkley throws it out. Bad turnover again for the Dragons. Dragons being a little sloppy. Well, we've talked about it. Sometimes you need players to rise up when the challenge comes. Dunlap is doing that for Dragons, and right now Wanamaker can't, so Jennings is taking that over because Binkley's going to be all over Wanamaker. So Jennings is saying, hey, I'll have to do it, and she's going to do it, and she's done very well so far for the Lady Trojans. Downing comes down, gets the ball.
Well, Courtney Jennings is listed as a junior, but if she loses here tonight, this will be her last game.
Miss Jennings, and a block by Dunlap. Rebound Barlow. Here comes Dunlap, and she's going in. Takes it up, and it's just off the mark. Barlow with the rebound, puts it up, and she's fouled.
That's either going to be Downing with her second or Jennings with her first.
I think it's Downing. I don't know. Let's see. One.
Yeah, they got Downing, Quinn Downing, her second foul. So that's bad news for Triton. She's their main ball handler. Doesn't score a lot, but she handles the ball and takes care of the pressure for the Lady Trojans. And Barlow can't convert on the free throw.
Well, Dragons need to make all. Downing has to come out. Dragons need to make all free throws.
Charlotte Morris checks in for the Lady Trojans. Yeah, as I was saying, Hannah Jennings, or Courtney Jennings, is graduating this year as a junior. So this could be her last game if the Lady Trojans were to lose.
Barlow misses both at the line. Fakes. Jennings doesn't want to take the three. And Wanamaker's having problems with Binkley, which we knew because Binkley was all over Parkman. The Vinny of the girls team defensively. Well, coach calls a new play. Yep, kind of a moving screen every time she goes past there between Bailey and Sechrist. And now, here's a quick shot. It's off the mark. Rebound. Throws it up. Misses. Dragons get the rebound. Stricker, what sight? And she misses, but she's shooting two. Got to put that in. It was a great pass. You want to see him make that, get that and one opportunity, but she can put these in, put the Dragons up by two with a minute left in the first quarter. And Dragons 0 for the last three attempts from the line.
They called the foul on Nicole Sechrist, their first. Team's fourth here with a minute 08.
And short on both.
Well, they've left 4 points on the board already with Barlow 0 for 2 and Stricker 0 for 2.
Well,
still, the only person for the Lady Dragons putting any points in has been Courtney Dunlap with all six of the Lady Dragons' points.
And Binkley's keeping Wanamaker from even shooting. Just about gets it that time. Here's a quick shot, and it's off the mark. Nobody on the other side, and Miller puts it in for two.
Number 14, Whitney Miller.
Well, I don't know. You tell me. I'm lost at the slow pace.
Now they're getting off on some rotations. They're overplaying Wanamaker, and then they're letting the backside rebound go. Miller that time puts it in. And you got some girls that aren't doing their job blocking out after the shot goes up and giving them second chance opportunities, much like the first quarter at Westville. Well, Lady Dragons are kind of sleepwalking their way through this quarter.
Dunlap for three.
Courtney Dunlap is the only Lady Dragon that came into
so
this
far
game awake.
There's a long three, and it's not going to be close. Well, yeah, that's Dunlap has nine, and we have left 4 points from the free throw line.
All right, so after one quarter, Courtney Dunlap nine, the Triton Lady Trojans eight. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back here after this message from Shepherd Chevrolet in Rochester. You're watching Argus Voice Sports on RTC4.com.
Hi, I'm Chris Smith, PGA Tour player and Rochester native. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester congratulates all of our local sports teams on another great season. Your hard work and dedication has made us all proud. We wish all of our local teams the best of luck in the postseason tournaments. Drive home a victory for your community. We are behind you here at Shepherd's.
All right, welcome back to John R. Nelson Gymnasium at Culver Community High School. After one quarter, the Argus Dragons are up 9-8 over the Triton Lady Trojans. And Andy, you've mentioned it, that the pace is just kind of slow right now between both teams. Courtney Dunlap has came here to play. She's got 3 three-pointers, two of them on the old-fashioned and ones, and then one of them from behind the arc. Lady Dragons had 4 turnovers in that quarter.
Well, they had as many turnovers as they had missed free throws. You can't be sloppy and expect to win games in the postseason. Stricker. 0 from 1 for the three-point line. I want to see her shoot that ball. Draw that defender out. Dunlap. Stricker.
Dunlap, Stricker, three, and it's just off the mark. Good shot, just off the mark. I want to keep her shooting there. Good pass, and now the Dragons need to wake up on this end. And Bailey better watch it. She's going to get that moving screen on her. Wanamaker gets the ball. And she goes to nowhere. Throws it up, and there's a quick lay-in.
Seacrest puts the bucket in, and the Trojans are back up by one, 10-9.
Well, Dragons need to start looking low. Barlow's open. Dunlap gets picked off. Wanamaker has it, kicks it over to Miller. Miller's going to the bucket, fakes, pulls back. Coach telling her to shoot that. Go ahead and try it. Jennings kicks it back out. And Binkley's all over Wanamaker. They kick it over. Not open. Kicks it in the middle. Lays it up and throws it under.
Well, Seacrest right now is really putting a hurting on the Lady Dragons. She just scored the last 4 points on little scoop layups, and Lady Trojans are up 12-9. And they got Barlow on an illegal screen.
That's the same thing that's been going on the entire time at the other end. Yeah, well.
And that's going to be Anna Barlow's second. So the Lady Dragons are all kinds of out of sorts, and if they don't get things back together here pretty quick, you know, they're going to be going out of this tournament real early. Triton's confident. They feel like they have the Lady Trojan or Lady Dragons number. They came really close in that second game, and they think they can get over that hump here in this sectional matchup.
Well, Wanamaker is in frustration mode.
And she draws the foul on Binkley, and that's going to be her second foul. So Kennedy Binkley and Anna Barlow both have two fouls here early for the Lady Dragons.
Well,
so Coach Teal is going to put Rachel Koontz in. Wanamaker makes the free throw.
Number 44, Rachel Koontz.
She's 2 for 3.
Number 30, Emily Calhoun.
And Calhoun's going to go back in for Binkley. So Barlow and Binkley got to take a seat on the bench with two fouls apiece. Wanamaker with the second free throw here. Can make it a 5-point Trojan lead, and she does.
Timeout.
And Coach Teal wants a timeout on the floor. It's 14-9. The Lady Trojans are ahead right now, and we're going to take a break. We'll be back here in just a moment. You're watching Argus Dragon Sports.
RTC Fiber Communications is now serving the community of Argus. Now you can enjoy the incredibly fast speed and reliability of fiber internet. Stream movies, surf the web, or watch your favorite local videos on RTC4.com. All from RTC Fiber Communications, now serving Argus. Give RTC a call today or check us out online at www.rtc1.com.
All right, we're back here with 5:17 left to go in the first half. The Lady Dragons have come out and scored 6 points in a row to start the second quarter and own a 5-point lead over the defending state runner-up, Lady Dragons.
I'm going to move down. My feet are driving Stevie nuts. All the bars right here, right in my between my leg, and it's annoying on this table. Well, here we go. Dragons are asleep. There's no other way to put it. And when you watch this tomorrow, you're going to say, wow, they are asleep. So, I don't know. Coach is going to have to get on them. The girls need yelled at something to fire them up, inspire them to get really motivated. Stricker, three, and it's off the mark. Ball's in the air, and Dunlap gets the rebound. Kicks it over to Courtney.
Courtney Dunlap goes through four and puts it in for two.
Well, it's going to probably take Courtney Dunlap just taking over this game right now. She's got all 11 of the points, and she's the only one here that doesn't want to see her career go south in the first game of the sectional.
Well, to say the least, it would be an upset. And there's a steal by foul. No foul. Ay, ay, ay. Did you see shots open? And the bank is good. Jennings just throwing stuff up and it's going in.
Jennings has 6 points here and puts the Trojans back up by five.
Well, Dunlap Morgan on that rebound was shoved basically out of bounds, big time. There's Stricker, Calhoun. I want to see Calhoun take that shot. Courtney over to Stricker. Stricker for two, and it's good.
So Macy gets her first bucket of the game, brings the Dragons back to within three. And the Dragons need to get a little energy here.
Dunlap's on Wanamaker. And there's a turnover.
All right.
Now Wanamaker is absolutely out of sorts. Out of the whole team for Lady Trojans, she's the one that's having problems. And everybody else is playing very well. Jennings has got, what, six or eight already?
Jennings has six, and Sechrist has four here in the second quarter alone.
Calhoun, Dunham, Morgan, fakes.
Traveled, yeah, doggone it. She gets called for that a lot. I hope over the summer she can work on that because it's she shuffles her feet when she takes off.
Coach
right there.
Saying, hey, shoot that. If you're open, take a chance. Miller over. Sechrist has it. Wanamaker. Dunlap's on her. Jennings kicks it down. All this, and we're down three.
Boy. Five-second call. Good defense by Morgan Dunlap that time.
Did you and see Bailey and Stricker battling? I like it. It was tough. Good battle.
Well, maybe that'll wake her up a little bit. She's been in a little funk here to start the game.
Well, she got her last bucket. That's going to give her some confidence. And I want to see Calhoun take a shot. Down to Dunlap. Koontz. Calhoun for three. And it's just off the mark. The Dragons have been almost over, except for Dunlap's 1 3-point attempt.
Not almost.
All right, they have been over, except for Dunlap's 1 3-pointer. Miller kicks it out. Jennings takes a little move. Tries to find somebody. Wanamaker wants nothing to do with shooting at the moment. Jennings looks. And Dunlap's on her. Kicks it over. And there's the steal.
Good.
By
Morgan.
Morgan Dunlap. Takes
finish
it to the other end and misses the layup. It was a great tip, but misses the layup, and that's just the way the Dragons have been tonight.
She had a little time. She could have stopped and just popped a little jump shot right there because
right
the Triton
glass,
player
yep.
had flown past her. But
it was a great defensive play.
Oh, yeah. And we've seen her do that several times.
Timeout.
And Coach Heckman wants a timeout. His Lady Trojans have gotten a little stale here. And with a minute 41 left, the Lady Dragons down three, 16 to 13. We're going to take a break.
Yeah,
we'll be right back.
Are you in pain from an injury or arthritis? What if there was a place that could meet all of your orthopedic needs? A place with some of the best orthopedic doctors and staff in the Midwest. A place where you're treated as a person instead of a patient. What if that place weren't in Chicago or Indianapolis? There is such a place. Rochester Orthopedics, your regional orthopedic specialist. When you're looking for comfort and relief, remember, trust the board-certified and fellowship-trained surgeons at Rochester Orthopedics.
All right, welcome back here. It's going to be the Lady Trojans ball underneath their own bucket with a minute 41 left to go in the half.
Well, needless to say, this has been one ugly half of basketball.
Well, they missed an opportunity right there. Bailey had flown open right there on that inbounds, and they didn't catch her.
Well, that's fine. Wanamaker for a quick three, and she's off the mark. Rebound goes to Sechrist.
No weak side rebound again by the Lady Dragons.
Shot, missed, rebound, Stricker. Dunlap gets the ball. Courtney sets it up. Goes across, goes up, and puts it in.
And one attempt again for Dunlap.
Marcus, number 10, Courtney Dunlap.
She doesn't want this to be it, Andy. She doesn't want this to be it. So
she's a competitor and a fighter, and she's doing very well for herself and the team. We just need to have a nice, I guess, chewing at halftime to get the rest of the girls to wake up. And it's good for Dunlap again.
She's got 14 of the 16 points here for the Lady Dragons, much like Stricker in the first matchup.
Yeah.
With 12 of the first 14. So Courtney Dunlap holding the Lady Dragons on her shoulders, saying, ride with me and we'll get this.
There's a steal by Morgan Dunlap.
Finish it.
Now she needs to go up, and she puts it in for two.
There we
That's
go.
That's much better out of the freshman Morgan Dunlap.
We've seen her spark us before,
yep.
South Central game over at the Winter Classic. And the Lady Dragons come all the way back from a five-point deficit, and they're up by
yep.
eight.
It's caused the freshman to pick it up. And battling freshman versus freshman.
I like this defense. Lady Dragons have gone man-to-man, and right now it's kind of stymied the Lady Trojans.
Yep. Well, Wanamaker's like shot twice from the... And this causing a timeout for...
Another timeout for Coach Heckeman. 16.8 seconds left. He's going to want to try and run something here to get a bucket at the end of the half. Want to thank all of our sponsors for Argus Voice Sports, RTC Fiber Communications, the Zone Sports Complex in Northern Indiana, H&H Contracting, Hereford Home Inspections, Argus Do It Best Hardware, In Stitches and Signs. I can't hardly do this with a song on. Mr. Trophy, CNS Outdoor Power Equipment, CNS Automotive, Haldeman Farm Management and Real Estate, Oliver Ford, State Farm Insurance, Alvin D. Morris, your agent in Knox, Indiana, and Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. Thanks to Scott Sager and JC and Abby and Alex and all the gang at RTC for helping us out this year. Hopefully this is not
Boy. All right, let's see what the defense is. They got Downing back in, the ball handler, and let's see what Calhoun can do on her. 11. Kicks it out. Sechrist. Miller, here it comes. And there's a foul.
Miller's foul. She'll go to the line.
Jennings is coming back in, and out comes Downing.
They're going to get Stricker on the foul, her first of the game. 3.9 seconds left.
Stricker? Kuntz, you mean?
They got Kuntz.
Oh. It was Kuntz. This guy, you blind. You blind.
Well, it looked like she fouled her to me.
Freshman misses free throw line.
Well,
Downing's back out.
Will she make it through the whole half then with no fouls?
Shut it. She is set up way out here, away from everybody, but that doesn't mean anything. Miller misses again. Kuntz with the rebound. Over to Dunlap. Dunlap. And just off the mark.
Looked good from here. It was off to the left a little bit. So Argus is able to battle back from a six-point deficit and go into the half with a 18-16 lead over the Lady Trojans. And we're going to take a break. We'll total up our halftime stats.
Now give me a few advertisements real quick while you
All
do
right.
the stats, and then I'm going to run down and get us some free beverages. Sports Zone Sports Complex of Northern Indiana, 2923 Van Vactor Drive, Plymouth, Indiana, 46563. Come down, see Rip, Barb Miller, Ted Hayden, Doug Griffiths, Dwayne Morton, myself. Soccer, basketball, volleyball, futsal. Get yourself private lessons. We have private lessons for volleyball, basketball, soccer going on right now. We'll have lacrosse, flag football, quarterback trainings with Bill Regan from Notre Dame. So it's anything and everything you want sports at the Zone Sports Complex of Northern Indiana.
All right, so your first half stats a little bit more evenly spread for the Lady Trojans. The leading scorer for the Lady Trojans was Courtney Jennings with 6. Nicole Sechrist had 5. Hannah Wanamaker with 3 points, and those were all on free throws. And Whitney Miller had 2. The Lady Trojans had 6 first half turnovers, including 4 in the second quarter. For the Lady Dragons, Courtney Dunlap with 14. She had 3 and ones, as well as a 3-pointer and a bucket. So 14 points for Dunlap, 2 points for Stricker, and 2 points for Morgan Dunlap. And that is your 18 points for the Lady Dragons here in the first half. The Lady Dragons had 6 first half turnovers as well. They were flip-flop. They had 4 first quarter turnovers and only 2 then in the second quarter. So going to have some adjustments here at the half, I think, for both teams. Probably see a lot of different looks here than you saw in the first half coming out in the second. I really liked when the when Kennedy went out with her second foul. Not that Kennedy was out, but we moved to a man-to-man defense. And I really think that did wonders against the Lady Trojans. You put Courtney Dunlap on Wanamaker, and you just don't have as many holes on the backside when you're trying to rebound in that situation. So we're going to take a break here. We got about 7.5 minutes before the start of the second half, and we'll come back with second half action here from game number 3 of Culver Community Sectional number 51, where your Argus Dragons lead 18-16 over the Triton Lady Trojans at the half. All right, welcome back here to John R. Nelson Gymnasium at Culver Community High School. Steve Stricker alongside Andy Stone.
Well, Steve, this isn't quite maybe the way you wanted to come back to your alma mater and watch the girls play, huh?
Well, here's the thing. It wasn't pretty.
Nope.
But we are up two after one, and we were down 6 points at one point in the second quarter. So you got to give the Lady Dragons credit there. They fought back, and they got the lead back, and they're up two at the half. And if they can kind of wake up here in the second half, you know, they've only scored 18 points in one half of action. That's not real good. We've seen them do that in several quarters this year. And I think the second half is going to be much better than the first, and I think they're going to kind of take care of business. I mentioned you had already gone off the air, but I mentioned the fact that I thought when Kennedy went out, not that Kennedy went out, but we switched and went to a man-to-man.
I think that helped us.
I think that did because they filled in. There was just too many gaps there with that box and one.
Well, we didn't do it much in this season, so we're not real strong at it. So I'd like to see us do man-to-man with Binkley on, Binkley's on Don.
Yeah,
Downing.
So they're
been a man-to-man it because Coach Teal noticed that it was working better.
And he's got Courtney Dunlap now on Wanamaker. To start the second half, we got the four starters with Morgan Dunlap back out on the floor for the Lady Dragons.
Seacrest doesn't try to go against Barlow. Jennings, Downing. Seacrest goes, kicks it over, and it's stolen by Dunlap. Gives it over to Morgan Dunlap and puts it in for two. Good pass. Better finish. I love it. And now there's the press. I was talking about it. And Binkley with the steal, and they're going to call a jump ball.
Jump ball is going to go over to the Lady Dragons. So two quick turnovers here, and a great transition bucket there by Dunlap, or Morgan Dunlap from Courtney. Gives the
Stricker fakes. Oh, she was open after that. Binkley looks. Gives it to breaking Morgan Dunlap, and she just misses. Ball's loose. And it's going to be rebounded.
I like the movement, though.
Yep.
I like the movement. Much more action going on so far than they had in the first half. And Downing's got a...
tipped by Binkley, almost stolen, and there's going to be the first foul on Stricker.
Well, Downing looked to me like she had an armbar against Binkley right there. No call.
Well, I heard Coach Teal say push off, so keeping it aware.
She's clearing out some space there with the Binkley Gardner.
All right, Miller comes and gets the ball. Miller not playing with quite the bit of confidence that she had last game. She's having some issues, and then Morgan, the freshman, Dunlap's been on her pretty tough. Downing picks it up and gets it over to Miller. Seacrest, Jennings, Stricker's on her. And Wanamaker has pretty much been non-existent this game.
Well, the frustrating part for Wanamaker, she had a section there where she got open, and they were not able to find her.
It's going to be off of Dragons.
Block out of bounds.
Yep. I'd say Stricker got the block, and Wanamaker's just forcing anything just to have an attempt to shoot it.
Well, right now she's gotten two shots from the free throw line, and that's been it.
Stricker, had her hand. And there's about a steal from Morgan Dunlap. Look at the hustle out of Morgan Dunlap. That's what I'm talking about.
Well, the freshman Morgan's come to play as well here, and it's going to stay Trojans ball on the jump ball call.
There it is. And Binkley hits the ground. Binkley's back up.
Travel, no call. Wanamaker got away with one. I think Morgan Dunlap might have knocked Binkley down right there.
Morgan is here to play. I love it.
She doesn't care if you're wearing white or black. She'll knock you down.
And it's off of her Jennings' leg, and it's going to be a foul or turnover. Reach in, knocked off of her.
So and three quick Lady Trojan turnovers, and the Lady Dragons are up four and looking to add to the lead.
Morgan Dunlap has it. Looks. Kicks it over. Binkley. Stricker. Go, Back over to Stricker. Barlow.
Well, she looked at Barlow wide
and
open on the post.
Puts it in for misses. And rebound goes to Stricker.
Oh, she tried to hit it off of Jennings and completely missed. And ended up just throwing it out of bounds. But it was a good effort that time.
Well, the Dragons are pressing. And this is what I was talking about. I called it in the first half. And you mentioned that they have to score. Well, they didn't score this time, and they're pressing.
Well, it's a little bit different.
There's a foul by Dunlap. Now be Dunlap's first. This press is causing them havoc.
First team foul, or second team foul on the Lady Dragons. First on Courtney Dunlap.
Miller's having a hard time with Morgan Dunlap. There's an illegal, and that's the third one on Downing. And she did. She totally pushed with her arms to keep Courtney Dunlap from coming through. And that's her third, and that's a very bad foul for the Lady Trojans.
Yeah, the foul creates a turnover, and Dragons looking to add to a four-point lead with 5:15 left in the third.
Well, this is where I want to see a nice post play from Barlow, or a good three from Stricker, or a nice and one from Courtney Dunlap. Barlow from the baseline and just off the mark. Jennings gets the rebound and has issues and gets the ball over. Seacrest breaks it. Kicks it over. Woo! Jennings, or Miller has it. Downing back to Miller, who's not paying attention. And Morgan Dunlap almost gets it. Downing looks, is not going to shoot it, and Binkley just kind of just says, hey, if you want to shoot from there, go ahead. Wanamaker for three, and it's good.
Anna Wanamaker gets her first field goal of the game, and it's a three-pointer, gives her 6 points on the night.
Well, that's where you rotate Binkley back over on her. Let Dunlap take a quick break. Picks up her feet. Dribble and she gets fouled, but they don't call it. Binkley fakes. Stricker. Morgan Dunlap. Binkley's wide open underneath. Lobbed of Barlow. Stricker. Somebody take it up. Dunlap gets the ball. Now Barlow's open. And there's a blocking foul, and that's the fourth on Downing. And Downing's mentally, she's so upset with herself because it's her fourth foul and she has to come out and she knows it's such an important game for her team. Stricker kicks it over. Binkley for three and it's just off the mark. Barlow gets the rebound. Morgan Dunlap drives, kicks it back over and it's stolen. And there's a foul by Stricker.
Second foul on Macy Stricker, third team foul on the Lady Dragons here in the second half.
Well, this game is going to do nothing but give North Miami hope for no matter who they play at this rate. Ay-yi-yi. Misses. Barlow tips, misses. Fouls, and one.
Well, Wanamaker starting to heat up here. She gets the and one, and they're going to get either Barlow.
Number 12, Anna Wanamaker.
Yeah, they got Barlow on her third foul.
I thought it was Dunlap that fouled her.
Well, they called it on Barlow, and Lady Trojans are back up by one, and Wanamaker's going to be at the line shooting with and one here in
The Lady Dragons are making it too easy on them. They're helping them.
All right, well, we're going to take a break. Let's see. In Stitches and Signs, located at 11189 State Road 10 in Argus. They do embroidery, screen printing, signs, banners, vehicle lettering, magnets, decals, T-shirts, and much, much more. You can give Matt and Bobby a call at 574-892-5956 or visit them on the web at www.institches.com. And
Teal's leaving her in with three fouls.
Well, the Trojans are up one now, and Wanamaker's at the line trying to put them up two here with the and one. She's got the last 5 points for the Lady Trojans. Make it six.
Well, Dragon's going to have to cover that a little bit better, put Binkley on her, and let Dunlap take a break. Dunlap's done a very good job on her. Dunlap, Morgan has it up top. Stricker. Barlow's open.
There.
And Dunlap gets it and misses. Tipped by Dar Barlow, and there's going to be a reach-in foul off of
looks like Wanamaker.
That's her second.
Going to be her first if it is.
Oh.
Yep, Hannah Wanamaker, that's
gonna
her
be
first.
Her, no.
It's her first.
Her second. Why don't you pay attention to the game?
Well,
there's a broken
anyway.
Play and the Dragons get it.
I hate it when I got the paper and you're still right.
I have a memory like a horse. Barlow for two. And it's in and out. Stricker with the rebound again. Caddy corner to Morgan Dunlap. He's throwing to Courtney and she misses it. Just about stolen from Binkley. Now it's switched. Jennings. Barlow. I don't want to make her. Good help side. Kicks it out. Seacrest. Misses, and it's going to be, well, I guess Stricker blocked it out of bounds. I didn't really catch that.
I think Barlow knocked it out.
Did she?
Yeah.
Okay. Misses. Rebound. Blocked by Dunlap. And Courtney didn't see her sister. Drives up and on the foul on the ground. And that should be Wanamaker's third. Let's see who he calls it on. Oh, they call it on Miller.
And that's going to be Miller's first. That'll be the team's third.
And Binkley, or Stricker gets it. Over to Binkley. To Dunlap. Get the ball low. Stricker for three!
Three-pointer puts the Lady Dragons back up 23-22 with a minute 30 left in the third.
Wanamaker. Morgan Dunlap just about steals it. Seacrest tries it, just about stolen again. Jennings, and it's no good. Rebound, Binkley.
Binkley fighting with Morgan. Got
Dunlap.
Stricker, no. Books. Stricker's running.
Dunlap for three, and it's blocked. Stricker gets it. Kicks it out to Binkley. A little jumper, and Binkley's off the mark. Rebound, Barlow. And stolen. Miller drives in. Barlow stops her. Dunlap gets the ball.
Dribbled it on the line, so it's going to go to the Lady Trojans with 57.7 left in the third. The Lady Trojans, or Lady Dragons, are up one.
Well, Dragons has got to wake up, but starting to come alive here. Binkley out on the ball. Miller gets over to Wanamaker. Bailey. Bailey can have it way out high like that. There's a touch by Morgan Dunlap. Here comes Miller all the way around. Kicks it over to Wanamaker. Nope, to Jennings. Wanamaker thought about it. And Dunlap tips it out. And Dunlap's battling for it. The ball's on the ground.
Oh, that's a good play by Wanamaker. She got possession
and calls
timeout. So a smart play by the junior right there to save the ball. H&H Contracting owner Rob Herford does concrete work, guttering, roofing, general contracting. Give Rob a call at 574-498-6013. Rob also owns Herford Home Inspections. You can call Herford Home Inspection before buying your new home. Herford Home Inspection will determine any issues you may have with the property. They can also give you a written report on site. Hereford Home Inspection strives to help make the most informed decision on the purchase of your new property. So you can give Rob a call at 574-498-6013. Whether you need a home inspection, concrete work, guttering, you've had some roofing done by Rob.
Yep.
Referred somebody to him for a home inspection the other day, you said?
The other day, yep.
So Rob and Jenny, they're good people. We've had Zane on. He's going to take your spot next year.
He can have it.
Yeah. So Lady Dragons are holding on to a one-point lead, 23-22, with 29.3 seconds left in the third. And it's going to be the Lady Trojans ball on the far sideline. After the timeout by Wanamaker.
Oh, boy. Here it goes. Let's see what the Dragons do here. Ball's to Miller. Dunlap. Miller comes across, and Dunlap's on her. Wanamaker kicks the ball out. Sechrist. Jennings. Wanamaker. Way high. Miller. And Binkley's on Miller. Jennings, Sechrist. And broken play. Here's a quick shot, and it's no good. Dragons hold them.
All right, the shot by Jennings, no good. After three quarters of play, the Lady Dragons hold on to a 1-point 23-22 lead. We'll take a break and be back here in just a moment with the final quarter of action from John R. Nelson Gymnasium.
Hi, I'm Chris Smith, PGA Tour player and Rochester native. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester congratulates all of our local sports teams on another great season. Your hard work and dedication has made us all proud. We wish all of our local teams the best of luck in the postseason tournaments. Drive home a victory for your community. We are behind you here at Shepherd's.
All right, welcome back. We got 8 minutes left in regulation here at John R. Nelson Gymnasium. Looking for the fourth contestant for Friday night's semifinal here in the sectional 51. The winner of this game will advance to play North Miami in the second game on Friday. And it was a 5-6 Triton advantage in that quarter.
Hardest ball to start the fourth quarter.
6-5, 6 points to 5 points.
Hey, boy. Hey. I'm falling asleep with my awesome game statistics here, boys. Dunlap kicks it over to Stricker. Stricker got them kind of fired and going with that three-pointer. Barlow, Stricker. Dunlap comes and gets the ball. And Barlow is open, and there she is.
And the foul. Oh, she misses the bucket, but she's going to get the foul. It looks like Sechrist will be her second.
Anna Barlow, foul. She'll go to the line and shoot two.
Anna's 0 for 2 from the line here this evening. See if she can put in a couple free throws, give the Lady Dragons a three-point lead.
Well, those four free throws in the first quarter sure would be nice about now, and that one's off.
0 for 3 for Barlow. One more free throw coming up here for the senior center.
Well, Dunlap helping her out with her breathing, and it's smooth.
So Anna Barlow gets her first points of the night, puts the Dragons up to 24-22.
Miller just about throws it away. Here comes Wanamaker. Stops and turns, kicks it back to Miller. Sechrist looks. Jennings back to Miller. Dragons up by two. Fourth quarter here. Sechrist. Nobody else has really shot tonight. And there's a steal by Dunlap. Right there to Stricker, and it's off the mark, and doesn't rebound. Tied up by Stricker, battles it back. And that should be Triton's ball.
Remaining possession, Triton ball.
Here comes the press. Miller can't get it. Jennings struggles, and it gets into Sechrist. Miller. Barlow. Boxer. Miller goes up against the senior and has it now. Miller's rattled Minoy, the freshman, not looking good in the face. She's a little stressed. Dunlap goes against her and loses it. Battles back, and it's going to be a foul. Yep, there's Miller.
Miller gets the foul. That's her second. Team sixth, so Lady Dragons, if they can hit some free throws, will be at the line 1-1 here after the next shot. Free throw.
Jennings, foul.
Whatever
Jennings,
I'm trying to say.
Jennings out. Barlow gets it. Over to Binkley. Fakes. Caddy corner to Stricker. I want Stricker to put some threes in. Caddy corner. Thrown away, but Dunlap reads it and catches it. Fakes. Goes around two. Kicks it over to Binkley. Stricker for three. Fakes. Has her in the air and takes a little jumper, and it's off the mark. Wanamaker gets it. Well, the Dragons are just not into it tonight with the shooting from the field, unfortunately. Too many bunnies, too many free throws so far, and it's allowed Triton to stay in this game. Stricker doing well. Miller with Binkley on her. Sticking like glue. Rotating defense very well for the Dragons. Causes them to kick it back out. And Miller's back out the top again with Binkley on her. Sechrist. Stricker. Ball gets over to Wanamaker. Fakes, drives, and blocked again, and shot. Rebound, and shot again.
Number 34, Charlotte Morris.
Morris puts the bucket in. She gets fouled. They're going to get Binkley on that foul. That's her third.
That's better than fourth for Barlow.
And Morris has an opportunity to give the Lady Trojans a one-point lead with the free throw, and it's good. So the Lady Trojans are converting from the free throw line. They're back up 25-24. We got 5 minutes left to go in the game.
Dragons are letting them hang around. Going to be a barn burner at this rate. Dunlap drives in. Shot blocked. Rebound Sechrist. Kicks it over. Miller goes. Dragons defense all over. Wanamaker way out. Picks up her dribble. Wanamaker. There's a foul.
You get Morgan Dunlap on that. That's going to be her first. Team's fifth, sixth. Team sixth. So both teams will be in 1-1 here. What's the next foul?
The girls are going to test their mettle, see what they can do. Binkley. Out high. Rotates. Lays it up and misses. Stricker with the rebound. Here goes Stricker, and Morgan Dunlap takes the lead. Oh, and she didn't get seen. Courtney has it. Stricker for three. And it's just off the mark. Rebound, Barlow. Takes it to the ground and loses it. And it's thrown away. Triton has the ball. Miller dribbles it down. Oh, boy. Downing's going back in. Jennings is going back in. Stricker on Jennings. Dunlap on Wanamaker.
Number 12, Hannah Wanamaker's foul. She'll go to the line and shoot the bonus.
It's going to be the second foul on Dunlap, and that's going to put Wanamaker at the line shooting 1-1. Downing and Jennings come back in for the Lady Trojans with 3:31 left. Triton's up 25-24. Wanamaker shooting 1-1.
Well, let's see what happens.
Wanamaker's good on the first. She's got 5 of 6 now from the line.
Let's see what happens here. Wanamaker's been solid from the free throw line and smooth as silk again.
6 of 7 for Wanamaker and gives the Lady Trojans a 3-point lead, 27-24. Ooh. We're down to the last 3.5 minutes, and Coach Teal wants a fifth timeout. Lady Dragons down by 3. We'll take a break, come back here in a moment. You're watching Argus Dragons on RTC4.com.
RTC Fiber Communications is now serving the community of Argus. Now you can enjoy the incredibly fast speed and reliability of fiber internet. Stream movies, surf the web, or watch your favorite local videos on RTC4.com. All from RTC Fiber Communications, now serving Argus. Give RTC a call today or check us out online at www.rtc1.com.
All right, welcome back here. We got 3:25 left to go. The Lady Dragons have been outscored to start the fourth quarter, 5-1. And they're not in a good spot right now with 3:25 left to go, down by 3. And they're having all kinds of problems here getting the ball in the bucket. Only 24 points scored here, Andy. This is normally a halftime score for the Lady Dragons, if not first quarter.
I don't know. Dragons just need to play their game. Take it to them. Play with the tenacity that they have. I want to see us wake up and play our game. We haven't done it yet tonight. Where's Kuntzy at when we need him? We need Kyle to rile him up. Dunlap gets it to Dunlap. Drives in, and there's 2. Here comes the press. Miller. Over to Stricker, and here's a steal. Dunlap sees the Stricker, and she's fouled.
Sorta. Well, she's going to be going to the line here. She's missed 2. Let's see if she can put in the free throws. It's going to be a foul on Courtney Jennings, her first.
Jennings has played very well tonight.
For these are 2 big free throws here for the junior Stricker.
And it's smooth as silk.
Makes the first. That's the big one. Ties the game up at 27 with 3 minutes to go, and she can give them a 1-point lead if she can get this one to go.
And it's in.
Good to go.
And this is what I was talking about, playing our game. Tenacity, intensity. And there's a steal for Stricker. Kicks it over to Binkley. Barlow to Dunlap. And it takes us to the last 2 minutes to wake up the 3 minutes of the game. And this is Dragons basketball. This is what we come to expect. Playing with intensity, desire, and heart. Dunlap goes over, kicks it, looks. Stricker's wide open for the 3. Kicks it down. Right over to Barlow. And that's off her hands.
Barlow can't handle a pass from Dunlap. Turnover with 2:31 left to go. Lady Dragons have scored the last 4 points since Coach Teal called that timeout, and they've got a 1-point advantage now.
It was a great set play. Unfortunately, just couldn't handle the hands, and there's a bad pass. And here comes a good chance for the 10-second call. And he has to call a timeout before he gets there.
Good job by Coach Heckman. He knew it was getting close. 2:22 left to go. We're going to take a break. It's getting exciting here from John R. Nelson Gymnasium. Lady Dragons pack up 1.
Are you in pain from an injury or arthritis? What if there was a place that could meet all of your orthopedic needs? A place with some of the best orthopedic doctors and staff in the Midwest. A place where you're treated as a person instead of a patient. What if that place weren't in Chicago or Indianapolis? There is such a place. Rochester Orthopedics, your regional orthopedic specialist. When you're looking for comfort and relief, remember, trust the board-certified and fellowship-trained surgeons at Rochester Orthopedics.
That's going to go. All right. Get going, Andy. All right. Welcome back here. We got 2:22 left to go in the game. It's the Lady Trojans ball. Dragons are up 1, 28-27. And Lady Dragons coming a little bit to life here in the last few minutes. A couple turnovers forced by Stricker. Two big free throws, and the Lady Dragons are back up by one.
And, Dragons had a great play set, ran perfectly to a tee, and just Barlow was unable to handle the ball from Dunlap. It was a perfectly ran play, and they were unable to get it. But the Dragons forced immediately after that a 10-second timeout before they got the call, and now they're in trouble again. And there's a steal by Morgan Dunlap, and lays it up for two! Huge steal for Dunlap! Wanamaker to Jennings. Back over to Downing. And back over to Jennings. Dunlap steals it. Downing gets the ball.
She pushes off every time.
And there's a throw. Ball's loose. Kicks it out. Nobody's touching her. Moves it back and around. And Jennings, Whitney Miller has the ball. Downing. Dragons up by three with a minute 45. Indiana basketball at its finest. Here we go. Downing has it. Tries to get it to Wanamaker. Can't. Sechrist. Barlow's on her. Kicks it over. Miller gets the ball. Morgan Dunlap coming alive. Keeping them from coming in. Stricker out on Downing. Downing's not a threat there. Wanamaker's definitely not a threat out by the white line. Miller. Morgan. Dunlap's on her. Dragons. Down to 1 minute now. Holding the press. Out to Downing. 27-30. Dragons are up by three. Triton has the ball. Downing comes back around to get it. 50. Miller. Shot. Misses. Rebound. Barlow. Gives it over to Dunlap. 46 seconds left. Dragons up by three, and here comes Dunlap.
All right, that's who you want to foul if you're the Lady Dragons. And that's going to be Sechrist is third, and Dunlap's going to be at the line here. She can make it a five-point lead if she can put both these free throws in. Got 40.7 seconds left to go.
0-for. If it was me, and I'm coach, they should have got a Barlow with the foul immediately when she had to rebound.
Right,
she is
right.
Having some problems. And missed by Dunlap, leaving the Triton Trojans to hang in there. Shot, Miller off the mark, rebound, Stricker. And there's a foul on Stricker. Gets Stricker to the line. 2-for-2 from the line last time, and another foul by Jennings. 29.2 seconds left. Dragons up by three. Stricker's at the line. 1-1. Dunlap missed the first front end of the last session. Let's see what Stricker can do. And Steve's moment of prayer here. Quiet, sitting. No worries. Stricker puts it in. Stricker has come alive. Couple crucial steals. Hustle work and four free throws in a row. And here's the press. We talked about it. Dragons up by five. 26 seconds left. Downing, not sure what to do. Dunlap, Downing pushing her hands straight out on her. And they're going to call a blocking foul.
That's all right.
Yep.
That's all right. So that's going to put
Downing.
Sechrist at the line, shooting two.
Downing stiff arms. She had her hands straight on the chest.
Yeah.
On that one, right in front of the official.
She's done it every time. She's done it every time. Coach Teal is going to try and ice Nicole Sechrist. Lady Dragons are up five with 15.9 seconds left to go. I don't even know where I'm at. CNS, here you read that.
We're at CNS Outdoors. Power Equipment. Owners Richie and Amy Miller, 574-892-5790. Located at North Michigan Street in Argus. Open Tuesday through Saturday. 8:30 to 5, and boy, why do we have to wait to the end to wake up? That's killing me. Come out and see Richie and Amy Miller, CNS Power Equipment.
All righty, here we go. 15.9 seconds left. Dragons are up 5. Nicole Sechrist is at the line shooting 2 for the Lady Trojans. The winner of this is going to move on to the second game. Game of the night on Friday to take on the North Miami Lady Warriors. And she puts it in.
That was one of the quickest shots I've seen. The clock's not running. She can take her time, but she gets it, looks, hits it once, twice, and then just throws it right up and off the mark. Rebound, Dunlap, and there's a quick foul.
Foul on Jennings. It's going to be her third, and she makes one of two. Dunlap at the line shooting 1-1 here. She's got to put these guys in. They're up four. She sinks them. The game's over. That's it.
Pretty much. As long as the Dragons don't do anything silly.
Yeah. There's no way they're going to get 6 points in 14 seconds.
Well, don't say that.
There's not. She puts these in. She's got to put them in.
And it's on.
Good shot there by Courtney Dunlap.
What's she at for the night?
Let's see. She's got 10, 14, 17. She's only got 3 points in the second half.
I was going to say. And four. Crucial free throws.
You know
solid
what?
As a rock.
Two of those four.
In the veins.
6 point lead. Lady Dragons
and
are going to advance.
Lawmaker takes it and it's blocked by Dunlap.
No foul. Let her shoot it. No foul.
And it's out by Stricker.
That's Dragon. All right. Dragons are going to move on. It's not a pretty thing tonight, Andy, but they're going to move on. And the name of the game is
win.
Win in advance. Win in advance. And I knew it wasn't going to be easy here tonight. It's hard to beat a team three times in a season, and the Lady Dragons have done it. They're going to advance. They're going to play the North Miami Lady Warriors on Friday night at 8 o'clock for the chance to move into the championship game here on Saturday. 28-34. And huge free throws down the stretch. Four by Stricker.
Two by Dunlap.
And
defense, the last 3 minutes of the game is Argus basketball at its finest. Waited till 3 minutes left in the game before we decided to play it. But that is basketball to a T, Argus Dragon style. Hustle defense, great shots, great thinking, composure, everything that goes along with it. That's what you have to have if you want to come out on top in postseason. Oh, boy. Argus Do It Best Hardware. Owners John and Darlene Vanderweel. Come to I see Mark, Lowell, Mikey, Spencer and the gang. It's everything you want for all your hardware needs. Full service, garden tools, paints, and everything else. Argus Do It Best Hardware. Gracie Siebert. I'll see Gracie on Saturday at futsal. She's going to be playing at the Zone Sports Complex. I tell you what. Well, Steve, not the prettiest game by any means, but a win is a win. And when it mattered most, the Dragons stepped up, and we played our game the last 3 minutes, and that's what we had to do.
Well, we held the Lady Trojans to 28 points. That's right under our average of 28.5. And Hannah Wanamaker led the Trojans with 8. Seacrest and Jennings both had 6. Whitney Miller had 2, and Charlotte Morris had 3. They had 6 turnovers, 15 turnovers all told, actually 16 turnovers for the game for the Triton Lady Trojans. Courtney Dunlap led all scorers.
Can't see very well. We found your glasses. They are.
Courtney Dunlap led all scorers with 18. Macy Stricker had 9. 7 big.
At the
second half, she had 4 huge free throws. 2 big steals right there.
The initial kickoff of our comeback was the 3-pointer, but then we let them right back in it, and then the last 3 minutes of the game, Dunlap with a steal. Morgan had to lay up off the steal. Steal with Binkley and Stricker, and then the quick inbounds where Stricker steals it again. 4 free throws, and then a great battle at the end. Dunlap with 2 free throws, and then at the very end, we didn't give him an option to really score, and we took care of everything we needed to do.
Morgan Dunlap with 6 huge points. She had 4 in the second half, and Anna Barlow with 1 of 2 from the free throw line, and the Lady Dragons advance. That's the key to the night. They advance.
Yep.
They moved to 20-2 on the year.
Not bad.
And they're going to be taking on North Miami again for the second time this year. on Friday. So Friday night, it's going to be a great night of basketball here at Culver Community. Game number one is going to feature the La Crosse Lady Tigers and the South Central Lady Satellites. That's a rematch of a game they just played a little over a week ago, and La Crosse knocked off South Central in that game in the Porter County Conference tournament. And then another rematch on in game number two, North Miami and Argus will battle for a shot at the championship game. The two winners will advance, and they'll play Saturday night here at 7:30. So we appreciate it. Yeah, we see you, Riddle. Yeah, we see you. All right.
Odell, get out of the way. You're ugly.
So we're recording. I'm just going to close this out. Right. I'm going to get everything down to RTC so they can get it on the air. For Andy Stone, for Alex Stern, Steve Stricker, and good night from Culver, where your Lady Dragons win in advance to Friday night's game. We'll see you on Friday. Hopefully we can get this live thing worked out by then. And good night, everybody.